For the creatives, the ones who see art in everyday moments, who imagine what could be and bring it to life. At Foret Credit Union, they believe in moving forward together, each member, each moment. This is your space to build, to explore, and to create a future that reflects your vision. Visit foritcu.org. Foret Credit Union, for those who dare to create. Federally insured by NCUA. The holiday season is here, and there's no better place to cozy up and connect with loved ones than at the Salishan Coastal Lodge. So this year, start a new holiday tradition, create unforgettable family memories along the stunning Oregon coast with a special offer for our listeners. Use code CITYCAST for 20% off your stay. Book your family's coastal retreat at salishan.com today with code CITYCAST and make the holidays truly magical. For years now, food critics and pizza experts have been calling Portland one of the best pizza cities in the country, maybe even the world. And when the Oregonian recently dropped its list of the city's top 15 pizzerias, we knew there was a lot to discuss. So today on CityCast Portland, we're talking with Oregonian food critic Michael Russell about the city's best pies, from the old school legends to the places that are pushing the boundaries of what a pizza can be. It's Wednesday, December 4th. I'm Claudia Meza, and this is what Portland's talking about. How have you been?
Good. Yeah, I've been training for a half marathon.
So really?
Running a lot. Yeah, I ran 12 miles on Sunday.
That's incredible.
And I'm in recovery mode right now. And I'm picking candy that my kids left on the floor up off the ground. So that's a treat for me after the podcast is done.
Floor candy. Always a treat. Well, I'm happy that you're on. It's been a while, and I feel like pizza might be the thing you love the most. Whenever we have you on, you seem the most excited to talk about pizza. You know, you kind of do have a love-hate relationship. I wouldn't say with Portland's pizza scene. I just think most things in general. So
how did I become the resident crank?
I don't know, Michael. Let's review the tape. What's your hottest Portland pizza take today? If I were to be like, all right, give us your opinion.
I'm going to steal one from my good friend, Gary Okazaki, who, if you're on Instagram, you've probably followed him, Gary the Foodie. And he thinks if the Michelin Guide ever came to Portland, they would probably give a star to a Portland pizzeria. Do you know which pizzeria he guessed?
I think Lovely's.
Yes, exactly. You got it. That was his pick too. So, yeah, anyway, that's not my hot take, but I guess if you were asking me for my own hot take that I didn't steal from a friend of mine.
Which I did.
You did. I actually think, even though I poo-pooed the idea that Portland had the best pizza scene in America 6 years ago when somebody said it, and 3 years ago when a couple of other people said it, I actually think there's a real chance that it's true now. And my reason for thinking that is that when I published my guide to the 15 best pizza places in Portland, 9 of the places on that list were new, not just from like the past 5 years, but new since 3 years ago, the second time someone called Portland the best pizza scene in the world. So I feel like if people were already saying that 3 years ago and our pizza scene is now like maybe 2 or 3 times better than it was then, like we might actually have the best pizza scene in America, which is to say the best pizza scene in the world.
I have to agree. I think a lot of it is competition. You know, like in order for you to open up a new pizza shop, it better be damn good.
It's wild.
We're making the best of the best, I think. So speaking of the best of the best, you set out to make a top 10 list and ended up with a top 15. Was your editor mad at you? Like, why'd you do it?
Just, you know, sadism toward editor. I think I really am his worst nightmare. He's like, hey, can you do a quick pizza roundup? And I'm like, that's 6 weeks later. Like, here you go. Here's 5,000 words. I just felt like it was time. I hadn't done a proper pizza roundup for 6 years. So a lot had changed from 2018 to the pandemic. And then, geez, it's really exploded since 2020, 2021. So, you know, I guess we have a bottomless appetite for it.
Okay, well, we've taken the liberty of sorting your groupings instead of just going through, you know, your top 15 and going through each one. We thought we'd shake it up here. We're going to do four categories. Traditional old school pizzerias, fancy ones that, you know, are trying to elevate the game, and pizzerias that specialize in regional styles, and then what we're calling the fusion spots. Like, they're borrowing other cuisines and like putting it into pizza. So let's start with the traditional spots, because a few that made your list are kind of the ones that are always popping off, like a Pizza Shoal, Scotty's, and I feel like I've heard enough about them. The two that I wanted to talk about were Red Sauce and Pizza Thief, because I don't think we hear enough about them.
Yeah, actually, I think Red Sauce in particular is one of Portland's more underrated pizzerias. They were faced with a, kind of a difficult proposition, which is that they opened right across the street from Pizza Jerk within like a week of Pizza Jerk opening. And if you haven't heard of Pizza Jerk, that was the sort of second Portland restaurant from Tommy Habits, who is the founding chef and co-owner at Bunk Sandwiches. Mm-hmm. Bunk was a big deal sandwich shop. Everyone thought he might do the same thing for pizza. And, you know, when it opened, like, Bon Appetit flew in, called it one of the three best pizzerias in America of that year. And it got a lot of local accolades. I actually am a huge fan of Pizza Jerk. And the fact that they didn't make my top 15 kind of blows my mind. And that might be like one other way I would point to like how good the pizza scene is like the places that just didn't make the list,
but are great too. Yeah. Totally.
I think Red Sauce was a little overshadowed by their neighbor, literally directly across the street, like on 42nd Avenue in Northeast. I also think I tried Red Sauce a couple times early on and I just didn't have that like, wow, this pizza is really good moment. Mm-hmm. But when I went back for this guide, and this is why it's important to actually go out and revisit places rather than just like relying on Yelp reviews or whatever to make your list like some places do.
subtle shade. All right.
Sorry, not sorry.
You're like, unless you burn the roof of your mouth, I don't want to hear it.
No. Yeah. So like I go to Red Sauce, we sat on the little back patio and the pizza was so good. They had a, you know, really like very Portland type of pizza, which is like peach with jalapeno. And honestly, it was one of the best peach pies I had. I had like six peach pies because that's kind of when the season when I was doing most of my eating overlapped with that. And it was up there. It wasn't the best, but it was top three peach pie. And yeah, just really, really impressed with what Chardell Dues is doing up there. It's the chef formerly at a Pizza Shoals. So really good
place. Yeah. I do want to shout out real quick. I want to shout out Red Sauce Pizza because on Mondays they do hoagies. Have you had them?
I actually haven't had the hoagies, and that's wild because I've heard so many good things. So I'll have to change that soon.
They look so good. I want to go for that hoagie. It looks amazing. I know we're talking about pizza, but just shout out that on Mondays they do have a pop-up with hoagies.
Yeah, and there's a lot of pizzerias that are like more than just pizza, you know.
Sorry, but I interrupted you.
Yeah.
Pizza Thief.
I mean, I would say Pizza Thief kind of snuck in. The roots of it are sort of this like LA style of pizza where maybe... I think specifically there's a place in LA called Triple Beam, which is from the Mozza restaurant group. And they make their dough in a very Portland style with like a little rye, some like, locally milled grains, that kind of stuff. But what like put the finger on the scale for Pizza Thief, they're a proper slice shop. And you go there and they have like eight or nine slices and people are like crowding in there for lunch, which I love. It's right on the edge of like industrial Northwest Portland, I want to say on Thurman. And the second thing is they actually also do a really good pan pizza, like Detroit Sicilian hybrid kind of thing out of a place nearby, which is Great Notion Brewing. You could walk there in 10 minutes. And so those two things kind of combine to kind of nudge them over the edge.
I love that you're like the proximity to beer.
I do love beer.
Just a quick note that Pizza Thief, according to John Notariani, is on Vaughn.
Vaughn. Thank you, John.
Okay, well, let's take a quick break here. And when we come back, the fancy pizzas. This episode is brought to you by Every Child PDX. Every Child PDX began as a response to children going through the foster care system alone. Volunteers can find rewarding community service opportunities and gain insight into the real needs faced by children in foster care. They also help foster parents get the support they need to continue meeting the needs of the children they're providing for. But Every Child PDX can only do this with direct monthly support. Your monthly gift in any amount allows them to help the community continue to show up for kids in need. Join the Every Child movement and help ensure that children do not go through their time in foster care without the support of their community. You can help make their experience a little less difficult. To learn more, visit everychildpdx.org. That's everychildpdx.org. Beaver State Market is an online shop where you can find unique, and I mean found only here, items that celebrate Oregon and support our local artists and businesses. Beaver State Market is also dedicated to partnering with local organizations whose mission is to enhance our quality of life. Like this year, they're proud to introduce a collection that supports the State Forests Trust of Oregon. Proceeds from these items are donated to support their work and increase opportunities for outdoor recreation and education. Everything from anglers to OHV enthusiasts, hikers, mountain bikers, and visitors to the Tillamook Forest Center. So shop at beaverstatemarket.com today and give a gift from Oregon this year. This episode is sponsored by BetterHelp. So how are you staying cozy during the winter months? For me, my favorite part of the season, aside from spending more time with friends and family, is getting to cook for them. I pour myself a little something, put on some records, and linger through a complicated recipe. It's my thing, it brings me comfort, and it's also how I stay warm and cozy during the season. But therapy is also a great way to bring yourself some comfort that never goes away, even when the season changes or you start getting busy all over again. It's helpful for learning positive coping skills and remembering to do all those things that bring you joy and keep you sane. Therapy is also helpful to learn how to set boundaries to get more of your time back, empowering you to be the best version of yourself. Find comfort this December with BetterHelp. Visit betterhelp.com/citycast today to get 10% off your first month. That's BetterHelp, HELP.com/citycast. How about places making fancier high-end pizzas? Like, who's leading there? I also just want to shout out that Ken's Artisan Pizza and Lovely's, of course, made that list. But again, those two get so much love and so much attention.
I like you're mining for the diamonds in the rough here. You know, places your listeners might not have heard of yet. I like that.
Exactly. And Cafe Ollie, I know people have heard of as well. But there's also No Saint and Bauman's on Oak. Quickly, just like Bauman's on Oak. That's brand new. Something that Brooke Jackson Glidden spoke about as one of her top new restaurants because of the quality of the bread. And I know there's a Cafe Ollie connection there. So can you explain like why Cafe Ollie and Bauman's on Oak, why they made the list?
Yeah, great question. So, you know, I think maybe like if you're looking for a through line in Portland pizza, there's a couple different themes you can kind of identify. And I think obviously one of the biggest and why a Michelin guide might look to anoint a place like Lovely's 5050 is the fact that we're really good at putting farmers market vegetables on pizza. So Whatever the season is, you walk into your favorite neighborhood pizza and they might be playing around with, like I said, peaches or nectarines or grapes or whatever like fruit or veg are in season right then.
Yeah, fiddleheads.
Fiddlehead ferns. Yeah.
Nostrana,
another one that didn't make my list. Good Lord. There's so many great pizzas.
Yeah, Nostrana's good too. Yeah.
They do a crab pizza in the spring, which is like, wow, it is so fantastic. So that's one. Number two is like just the number of bakers that open pizzerias. Mm-hmm. Like, I feel like that's sort of the subtle thing. Darby at Pizza Thief, who I mentioned, Pizza Shoals. Brian Spangler was a baker out in Shoals, Oregon, which is like a tiny town. Sort of like almost feels more like an intersection when you're driving through it. That's where a Pizza Shoals started before they moved to Portland. He was a baker there. Another through line between a Cafe Ollie, which maybe people don't think of as a pizzeria, but they have great pizza, and Bauman's is a chef named Daniel Green, who has roots as a baker. He also was responsible for the pizza at in the very early days of Chicoria, which was Ava Jean's sort of like Midwestern Wisconsin tavern pie. They called it party cut pizza, where it's like crisscross cut. So you get these little square and, you know, corner slices that are triangles. So this is an incredible baker. And as Brooke said, you could go to Bauman's and just have this like sourdough bread, and it might be like $9 for the bread, but it'll be the best bread you've ever had in your life practically.
Yeah, because he's sourcing the water, right? He's going to special places just to get the water, is what Brooke was saying.
No, she's right. Well, I think he might be almost slightly embarrassed about this, but he's got a buddy who has a farm in Corbett, which is, you know, just east of Troutdale, and there's a natural spring there. He goes there and I guess fills up jugs or whatever with this natural spring water because he doesn't want to worry that our chlorinated water will impact his sourdough starter, is what he told me. And I shouldn't say he's embarrassed. I don't know if he's embarrassed or not, but he said people are kind of making a big deal out of it. It's a little wild that he does this, like drives to Corbett.
I know, he's like, why is everyone talking about this? Because it's insane.
I just drive to Corbett for my water. And like us in Portland, we're like, dude, we have the best water in the world. Yeah, what are you talking about? But okay, like I'm not a scientist. Maybe you don't want to add chlorine to your sourdough starter. It actually kind of makes sense when you think about it. Like if you have the option to not do that. Mm-hmm. But anyway, and the results speak for themselves. Sourdough bread is great. But once a month, this place, Bauman's on Oak, they do a pizza pop-up. And like, again, it's crazy to say this in a town this good, but it might be the best pizza in the city. Like, honestly, if they did pizza every night, this place would be like, you would have to get a reservation. You'd be lining up. It would be like, you know, a Pizza Shoals on a Friday or Ken's literally every single day because they're so busy at Ken's. But Bauman's is the perfect sort of interconnection between those two threads. It's the dough is just fantastic. And then the toppings are extremely seasonal. Like I said, there was a peach pie. It was like peach and pancetta. Then the next month I went, it was nectarine. The month after that, it was these beautiful ripe red grapes. And meanwhile, they have Alex Williams, who's the CDC at Lovely's 5050, like actually making the pizzas in this beautiful oven. And oh my Lord, if you get a chance to go, I think they're taking December off and maybe January. Their problem is their oven is located outdoors. So they just can't do it during the winter. Yeah. So they've been kind of popping up. They did like a Tlayuda pop-up at Astral. Wow. Then they were at Jeju doing wood-fired pizza. And that was like one of the hardest tickets to get of the year, basically. Highly, highly recommend structuring your eating calendar next year around trying to get into Bauman's pizza pop-up. It's that good.
Wow. So I didn't know that. So Bauman's not only has like the Cafe Ollie through line, but then someone from Lovely's is also working there?
Isn't that wild? And you know,
that's crazy.
Alex, I think, made the peach and pancetta pie, was like, not just like made it physically in the oven, but actually like also like did the recipe development or whatever you want to call it. Mm-hmm. And they're beautiful. Perfect amount of toppings, perfectly ripe fruit, perfectly ripe vegetables. I mean, there's only a few pizzerias in town that like make my eyes roll back in my head and just like, oh, wow, this is incredible. And it's like a Pizza Shoals pretty much every time, Bauman's, and then occasionally Scotty's maybe, and maybe occasionally Lovely's. Like there's only a handful of places that hit that like really, really high mark.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk about places specializing in regional styles, because I know there's a lot of like Connecticut style pizzas and stuff. But you mentioned Ranch, Demos, Grana Pizza, and Lombardo's. Can you just choose two of those and like tell me why you picked them?
Well, the obvious and interesting like regional specialty pizza that was a big revelation for me was Lombardo's. Like that is a place that I don't think is on, I mean, if you live in North Portland, you've probably heard of it or driven by it.
Yeah, yeah. I've had pizza there.
You've had pizza there. Yeah. If you're like a University Park resident, yeah, you've probably gone once or twice. But like this place is not on the overall Portland pizza scene map at all. Their style is New Jersey style, which is extremely adjacent to New York style pizza. So if you think of a New York slice shop, you're really close. But they do a couple of things different. They do a tomato pie and they do like a New Jersey style bar pie, which they claim are sort of like very New Jersey style. And I think this kind of, they're good. They're good. They're not like blow you out of the water, best pizza you've ever had. I'd like the dough to have a little more character, but maybe that's just because I'm spoiled for all these sourdough local grain pizzas.
I thought the exact same thing, I want you to know. When I had it, and I thought, you know, it was also, I went like maybe the first week they were on and I loved the vibes. I thought it was good, but I was just like, cool, pizza.
Yeah. And I think like them being there and making, yeah, pizza, right? This kind of speaks to why Portland is such a good pizza scene. This has been said before, but you know, if you do a list of the best pizzerias in New York, well, like the New York Times did a best slice list just a few weeks ago. And I thought it was really edifying because that list had a lot of delicious looking pizzerias on it. It also had a lot of pizzerias that looked exactly the same. And it had some historical 100-year-old places that, frankly, I've been to and do not measure up. So the thing about Portland that people have said, and I agree with, is that we don't really have a regional pizza style here. So we're able to do whatever we want. And it can be Vietnamese, you know, ingredients on a pizza. It can be a vegan Detroit style pie. Like, we have those things here because kind of anything goes. You know, no one comes to a pizzeria like expecting a really specific thing. If we did have a style, it would probably be that sourdough seasonal thing I've been talking about.
I think
about.
It's sourdough seasonal. I just think it's like,
it's getting there.
I think like if somebody were to like satire, you know, Portland pizza.
The Portlandia.
Yeah, the randomest shit on a pizza with like sourdough, that water, you know, it was like brought in miles and miles. You know, it would be that whole thing, that preciousness to it. And I enjoy it. But yes, Lombardo's was good to you.
Yeah, yeah, it's really good. And I think the thing that like you and me kind of clued in on that pizza is actually a very New Jersey thing. I don't think the crust there necessarily has a ton of character. It might have just a certain plainness, a certain crackery crispness to it that is true to style. So when I say I didn't like, when I say I like, oh, I wish it had a little more character. Well, okay, but that might be me bringing my Portland, you know, thing to the table. So anyway, a really good pizzeria and I was really glad I found it. And then the one that I think is another regional style that like I've heard people say they prefer this place to what you get in the actual region where it's from is Demos. And Demos does a specific style of pizza for New Haven, Connecticut, which some people call the best pizza city in America. And in order to get the sort of like super charred style of pizza that they serve in New Haven, Demos has like a two bake process. So they first bake their pizzas in an electric deck and then they finish them in a wood fired oven. So you get that sort of Portland wood firedness. You get that extra char, which is super New Haven. And these pizzas come out like really crackling, really super deeply charred. And frankly, as I wrote in my little review, this is like a little too charred for me, a little too dry for me in terms of pizza, but like they absolutely nail the style. And again, I had people emailing me after the list came out telling me like, wow, this is like, we go to Demos all the time because we actually think it's better than the pizza where we're from, which is New Haven. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah.
You know, I know Gracie's is also of that style. I've had Demos and Gracie's. I prefer Gracie's, but I think that when I tried Demos, it was a little too dry for me, just a little, you know, but I might try it again, you know.
I think Gracie's is an interesting thing because they weren't on my list, partly because they're like literally closed right now, but Gracie's is like, I think the owner is also from that area, but that pizza to me is like way more in that Portland style we were talking about than the New Haven style. You know, it's got a strong sourdough flavor, wood fired oven, et cetera, et cetera.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's look at these couple fusion spots that you wanted to shout out. I know Riva and Pan con Queso also made your list. Tell me about these two. I'm surprised. I think Hoppe didn't make it. I know like New York Times picked Hoppe as one of the best.
Yeah, and that's specifically because Hoppe's in Beaverton, and we set our...
So this is only Portland,
It's only Portland. Yeah.
Okay, so quickly, Riva and Pan con Queso. So tell me about Riva.
Well, okay, what's funny is like both of these pizzerias like to play with Mexican flavors, among others, but they kind of couldn't be more different. So Riva, the chef worked at Pizzeria Otto, which is a Neapolitan place. So his style of pizza is in that Neapolitan tradition where it's wood-fired ovens. He does like probably my favorite margarita in town, which is, you know, a simple pizza with really bright tomato sauce, mozzarella, and basil. That's all. It's like if you're in an Italian restaurant and they have pizza for kids, that's probably the one they're going to serve you. And then your kids pick the basil off because they're too picky about green things. But at Riva, the claim to fame is something they created called a pizzaleata. Well, I think we've talked about it before, actually. But essentially, it's a pizza where instead of tomato sauce, it's like refried beans, really chewy cheese. Sometimes you'll crack a fried egg. Sometimes you'll throw in some chorizo.
Yeah.
Sometimes you'll throw in like a romesco sauce. He makes this very like fusion-y because the chef, he worked at Andina. He's from Mexico. His wife is Honduran. So his wife's mother makes this Honduran dish called baleadas, which are giant tacos with refried beans, cheese, and egg. And he turned this baleada, which is delicious, into a pizza. He calls it a pizzaleada. And then he doesn't just serve it like a pizza. He actually folds it up in the style they do in Naples, which is called portafoglio, which is like folded in half and then folded again into quarters. And then you can take this pizza to go. I can't really imagine Italians like eating a sloppy, messy pizza while walking around. Like that just, I don't know. That doesn't, I can't see that happening, but I guess it does. So
Riva does this, is what you're saying?
Riva does this, yeah. And it couldn't be more fusion. There might be like a Peruvian hot sauce, a Honduran dish with inspiration. There might be some Mexican chorizo added. And then it's done in a Neapolitan sort of format that you see almost nowhere in Portland. So that's very cool. Then the other one you mentioned is pan con queso. So another place that draws inspiration from around the world. In this case, it's primarily Mexico. And I think their signature pizza is probably like their summer corn esquites pizza or the chorizo con papas. Like one of those two is...
Ooh, chorizo con papas sounds so good. I want that right now.
Are you telling me you've never been to pan con queso?
I've never been to pan con queso.
Oh, come on. Put it on your list.
I will blame my partner. She's not a big pizza fan. She's just like bread. I get it. You know, I do want to try pan con queso, which by the way, if you don't know, means bread with cheese in Spanish.
Let me throw this out there for your partner.
Okay.
So they started at Living House Brewery as sort of a pop-up and they recently moved to their own little tiny elevator sized space in Creston Kenilworth. I think it's on Gladstone. John, you can correct me if I'm wrong. but it's right next to a bar called the Holy Ghost. They actually have a whole margarita cocktail menu, like, you know, three or four options. There's a patio.
So you're saying alcohol near the bread.
Yes.
You know what? You're really speaking her language. I think she just perked up.
If she's not in this pizzeria, also has like five or six or seven vegetarian options last time I was there. Mm-hmm. There's also a Chinese restaurant called, I want to say 28 Tigers right around the corner that's all connected in the same complex. So you're like allowed to bring the food in. I mean, it's kind of got food cart pod vibes, but, you know, super fun. Yeah, I think there's something for everyone.
Cool. Well, thank you for that pitch. I hope that I get to eat a pan con queso soon.
You got
to
fill that major hole.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think when I posted this list, I was like, don't comment unless you've been to Lombardo's and pan con queso, because like that means you just don't know.
Okay. Well, this is my last question. If you were to open up your own pizza restaurant, I'm curious, in Portland's already very, as we've covered, competitive and crowded market, what would you do?
I'm not sure I would. yeah. God, would I just go to Seattle and open a pizzeria up there? I don't know. Aren't we fully stocked here? I think there might not be room for more, although people do keep opening more. I do think there's room for like a really good deep dish place. We have a couple of options, Via Chicago on Alberta. And there's one that's from my neck of the woods called The Star in the Pearl District. And like growing up in the Bay Area, there was like a surprisingly good deep dish pizza scene. And it got even like better after I left. And The Star was a big part of that. I don't know.
Just thinking of something getting better once you leave is always just like, why? What did I do?
Yeah, it's like when my parents put the hot tub in my childhood bedroom. Come on, guys. Where was that when I was a kid? Yeah, The Star opened here and I think it's pretty good. I don't know if it's quite as good as like the early days of The Star, Big Star. It has two different names and I'm confused by that in the Bay Area, but I think it's good. But I think there could be like a really, really, really good one. I don't know.
Okay.
What would you open? What would your pizzeria of choice be?
Oh my God. You know, I feel like too intimidated to even answer because like there's just so much good pizza. Like I've never thought of like, oh, you know what kind of pizza I wish there was in Portland? Never had that thought, not once. The one thing I do wish there was more of though, were slices to go. That's all. I feel like we're a whole pizza pie town or nothing. And I do love slices.
Okay. So that is part of the reason that Scotty's made number two on my list. And it bumped Bauman's, which like, again, I said on this podcast, Bauman's might have the best pizzeria in town. So I ended up putting Bauman's at three and I bumped Scotty's up to two because they are a legitimate slice shop, especially the one in Northwest Portland, which I imagine a lot of people actually haven't been to. It opened like pretty quietly during the post-pandemic time. So I think actually we have a better slice scene than you say. I mean, you've got
We have one slice. Okay. So
Baby Doll's great. Scotty's okay. is great. Pizza Cat's really good. Meta Pizza actually has these really good square slices that are worth trying. Okay. I could go on.
All right. Well, thank you.
You're wrong.
thank you for proving me wrong. Well, Michael, as always, we appreciate your time and your knowledge, extensive knowledge of the Portland food scene. I hope to have you back on. I know you're a busy guy with messy children and always running, but I hope that you come back.
Absolutely. My pleasure. Thank you.
That's all for today here on CityCast Portland. Thanks so much for listening. If you enjoyed the show, please share it with a friend, rate, or leave us a review. It really does help us out. We'll be back tomorrow morning with more from around the city. Until then, see you at Slim's.